Very good afternoon. Today we are discussing in this session the discrete Fourier transform. Myself, Dr. Rajendra Dubey, as working as a professor, Electronics and Communication Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. The learning outcome of the discrete Fourier transform. At the end of this session, student will be able to explain the concept of discrete Fourier transform. The content of DFT includes the frequency domain sampling, which is very important, and the reconstruction of discrete time signal. After doing the sampling, the reconstruction is very essential to recover the original discrete time signal. And after sampling and reconstruction, how we can get the equation of discrete Fourier transform. To learn about the frequency domain sampling, we have to see the aperiodic discrete time signal concept of with respect to the Fourier transform. If the frequency spectrum with the aperiodic discrete time signal can be represented as the summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity with the discrete time signal x of n e raised to minus j omega n. If we can evaluate this omega at 2 pi k by n, then the modified equation is represented with respect to this frequency as with respect to the k 0 to n minus 1. Let us see how we can represent this frequency spectrum. This frequency spectrum is the periodic repetition of x of n with the n sample, number of samples has been shown. If we are selecting the range in between 0 to 2 pi, and if the spacing between two samples has been considered as delta omega, then at each point we are representing its repetition with respect to the fundamental period as represented as x of k delta omega n. So this is the frequency domain sampling defined with the frequency range. Frequency range generally we are selecting as in between 0 to 2 pi, equal spacing, and this equal spacing will give the correct adjustment of the sampling concept with respect to the Nyquist criteria. If we are dividing the inner sum in between the range minus n to minus 1, 0 to n minus 1 to n to minus infinity, that is, if we are representing the frequency sampled at 2 pi k by n with the range minus infinity to infinity. So this frequency domain sampling, if we are representing as the basic equation with respect to L, as L is equal to minus infinity to infinity, and if we are considering L as with 0, then the range we can have summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi k n by n. If n is equal to minus 1, then we are having a range minus n to minus 1, so on. Generally, we are representing in such a way that it shows the periodic repetition of the inner sum ranging from the value n to n minus ln, and interchanging the order of the summation will give the periodic repetition of the signal that has been represented as xp of n in terms of x of n minus ln with the range of L. Generally, we are mentioning previously also, it is minus infinity to infinity. In this case, the capital N is the fundamental period, and the frequency domain sampling will give the measurement in terms of the linear combination of exponential signals in terms of the Fourier series, and this Fourier series is represented as xp of n is equal to summation k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 with the Fourier coefficient Ck e raised to j 2 pi k n by n, and this Ck will give the actual concept of the frequency domain sampling, and we are showing in terms of the range k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 with the periodic repetition n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 in terms of the fundamental period. Then if you can compare this with the previous equation with this equation number 6, then the value of Ck can be written in terms of the frequency spectrum as 1 by n x of 2 pi n into k. So if you are showing this xp of n as a periodic repetition as x of 2 pi k by n, and if we are considering the number of samples in between 0 to n, suppose if you are having a sample as L, if the fundamental period, if it is less than L, what will be the situation? If the fundamental period is higher than L, what will be the situation? And then what will be the condition or the result when n is equal to L? When fundamental period is equal to the length of the sequence L, then there is no problem of reconstruction of the original signal. We can recover that signal x of n with the periodic repetition xp of n. If n is greater than L, then again there should not be any mixing or the aliasing problem, since the fundamental period is higher than the length of the sequence. So in this case, the reconstruction is very good and we are recovering the original signal. But if n is less than L, then there is always a chance of mixing of two signals, and this mixing of two signals will not give the recovery or the reconstruction of the discrete time signal. This is the fundamental point that has to be remembered for defining the equation of discrete Fourier transform as x of n is equal to xp of n if and only if the condition is n is at least equal to L or n should be greater than L. So this will give the calculation of x of n equal to periodic repetition xp of n in between the range 0 to n minus 1. Otherwise, this xp of n has been represented equal to 0. Now let us recall the equation, that is xp of n is an aliased version of x of n as represented with the basic equation summation l is equal to minus infinity to infinity in terms of n minus ln the fundamental period. Then we are defining a sequence x of n in such a way that it should represent xp of n with the range 0 to l minus 1. Otherwise, if you are considering less than L, then it will give the value equal to 0. So that will not show any periodic repetition of x of n with respect to the fundamental period n. So in this case, either we can represent in terms of capital N or in terms of capital L to give the correct frequency spectrum representation as x of omega ranging from 0, n is equal to 0 to L minus 1 x of n e raised to minus j omega n. If we are sampling in between 0 to 2 pi, we can represent this as the frequency samples which are equally spaced ranging from k is equal to 0 to n minus 1, satisfying the condition of n at least equal to L or greater than L, then the definition will represent as the discrete Fourier transform. The Fourier transform will give the frequency analysis or the Fourier transform representation of a DT signal. In digital signal processing, this Fourier transform we are mentioning as x of k, which is sampled at the frequency 2 pi k by n, will give the basic definition of DFT. The range of this k is again can be given in terms of the fundamental period from 0 to n minus 1. If it is satisfying the condition n equal to or greater than L, we are reaching to the definition of discrete Fourier transform correctly. And if we are achieving the DFT, there is always 100% chance to recover the sequence x of n from frequency samples, and this recovery of the signal or the sequence x of n we are calling as inverse discrete Fourier transform. Again, this inverse discrete Fourier transform, it is represented in terms of the fundamental period with the number of samples that can be considered n is equal to 0 to n minus 1. Condition again here in IDFT, it is n should be at least equal to L or greater than L, then and then the recover of that sequence x of n is always possible, and then we can make the representation as IDFT. Now, in most of the applications, this definition, discrete Fourier transform as well as IDFT, both are very useful since it depends upon the frequency domain sampling concept and satisfying the property of the periodicity. If we are representing this e raised to minus j 2 pi k n by n in terms of the Tweedle factor, then this Tweedle factor or the cyclic factor always give the periodic repetition. So after every n sample, they have been the repetition of same values where it will show the correctness of the definition what we are getting from frequency domain sampling as x of k. As well as the IDFT, x of n, it is also will represent in terms of the fundamental period. Again, this will again we can represent in terms of the Tweedle factor. If we are writing in terms of matrix form, then the cyclic or the periodicity property of Tweedle factor represented in inverse matrix form, always it is possibility to have the result of x of n. So for this, we are having the references we are taken from the Bible of the DSP, that is John Prokes and Mankiewicz, that is 4th edition. And in most of the DSP applications, we are using DFT, where the use of DFT always give the representation with various properties, representation with respect to the circular convolution, representation with respect to the fast Fourier transform, which is very useful for various applications in signal processing. Thank you.